Hello students, in today's class we shall discuss about the Fajans rule, which is quite important for examination point of view from the unit chemical bonding and molecular structure. So first of all, to understand the Fajans rule, we will discuss about the partial covalent character in ionic bonds. Two extreme types of bonds are ionic and covalent, you know very well. In fact, most of the heteronuclear bonds like NaCl, alkali chlorides like KCl, NaCl have intermediate characters. Even in pure ionic compounds, there is some degree of covalent character. Among alkali chlorides, which is most ionic? This is question before us. Among alkali chloride, which is most ionic? To answer this question, we will apply here Fajans rule as a tool to solve this question. So first of all, we shall discuss about the Fajans rule. Fajans rule. To understand this rule, let us first understand few terms. First term is polarizing power. It is the extent to which a cation can polarize an anion. Means polarizing power is for cations. You can see here. First we have to understand, no compound is 100% ionic or 100% covalent. Or you can say ionic or covalent is a relative term. Here you can see two ions shown without any polarization. Here positive ion and negative ion. Assuming that the bond is completely 100% ionic, that is this pair is ideal ion pair. On the other hand, if you see that here, this is the cation and this is anion, right? And these are what? These are the outermost electron clouds. So here, when cation approaches anion, it will distort electron cloud of anion. You can see in the starting, it is spherical. But when this cation approaches this anion, there is a distortion in the shape, or you can say there is a distortion in the electron cloud of anion. So polarizing power, basically it is the extent to which a cation, means this cation has ability to distort the electron cloud of anion. So this is called polarizing power. It is the extent to which a cation can polarize an anion. And you know that polarizing power is of cation, and that is directly related with the charge density. And charge density is nothing but it is the ratio of charge to volume. Or one can write, polarizing power is directly proportional to charge to volume. Means greater the volume, smaller will be the polarizing power. Or higher the charge, higher will be the polarizing power of cation. Means more charge density, greater the polarizing power. Here, because this charge density is directly related with the polarizing power of cation, greater is the polarizing power for that cation. Or you can say smaller the size of cation, higher electron density will be there, and if higher electron density will be there, more covalent character will be there. Another term is polarizability. Polarizing power, remember, polarizing power is for cation and polarizability is for anion. It is the extent to which anion can be polarized, or ease with which anion can be polarized. Polarization is the distortion of spherically symmetrical electron cloud to unsymmetrical cloud. You can see polarization. Here this anion is going to polarized by the polarizing power of cation. Electron cloud, you can see there is a distortion in the electron cloud of this anion by this cation. We have some postulates for Fajans rule. This rule can be stated on the basis of three factors, which are size of anion, charge of cation or anion, and third is the electronic configuration. First is charge of the ion. Smaller the size of the cation, larger the size of anion, greater the covalent character in the ionic bond, because you know charge density is the ratio of charge to volume. If small is the size of cation, volume will be less. If volume will be less, then the charge density will high. If charge density will high, then the polarizing power will be high, and hence ultimately what you will get, the compound will be more covalent when there is a small size of cation and larger size of anion. Second is charge of the cation or anion. Greater the charge of cation, greater is the covalent character of the ionic bond, because larger the size of anion, you can see larger size of the anion, less is the effective nuclear charge that holds the valence electron of the ion. Since the last electron is loosely bound in large anion, because effective nuclear charge is less, it can be polarized by cation, making the compound more covalent. Greater charge on cation or anion, higher will be the charge density, and if higher will be the charge density, you can see higher will be the polarizing power. You can see calcium chloride is having more covalent character, NaCl will have ionic character, and covalent character, you can see that will have the lowest value of melting point. CaCl2 will have lowest value, that is 1045 Kelvin, and NaCl, which is ionic, because ionic bond has more melting point, high melting point, that is 1073 Kelvin. Another point is electronic configuration. For cation with the same charge and size, cation with 18 electrons shell configuration, that is pseudo inert gas configuration, have greater polarization or greater covalent character than the cation with 8 electron cell configuration. Means the cation having the 18 electron, that is pseudo inert gas configuration, will have the greater covalent character than that of the cation having 8 electron cell configuration. So you can understand it by taking the example. If we take example NaCl and CuCl, covalent character, we are going to compare the covalent character. You can see the cation Na plus and Cu plus. In NaCl cation is Na plus, in CuCl cation is Cu plus. Na plus electronic configuration is 2s2 2p6, 8 electrons, electron cell configuration 2+6, 8, and in case of copper plus 3s2 3p6 3d10 electronic configuration, here 2 6 10, 18 electronic configuration. As we have already discussed that 18 electron cell configuration will have higher covalent character, right? Here d orbital, in case of Cu plus, d orbitals which are poor, which will have poor shielding effect, so effective nuclear charge will high in case of copper plus. Copper plus ion polarize the anion more, that is Cl, copper plus ion polarize the anion more, that is Cl, than Na plus ions. Hence CuCl is slightly covalent and insoluble in water with lower melting point, and in case of CuCl melting point is 705 Kelvin, and in case of NaCl, which is ionic, And if it is ionic, then the melting point will be high. You can see 1070 Kelvin, and it is soluble in water. We have a relationship that solubility is directly proportional to ionic character, and ionic character is inversely proportional to covalent character. And we can easily understand from this concept that melting point is inversely proportional to covalent character. As we have seen that NaCl is ionic, that's why the melting point is high, and CuCl is covalent, that's why the melting point is low. So melting point is inversely proportional to covalent character. And Fajan rule, covalent character will be favored according to Fajan's rule when small size of the cation or larger size of the anion, high charge of the cation and anion, and the cation having 18 electron shell. Means if these conditions are fulfilled, then the covalent character will be high according to Fajan's rule. Now we have the questions like, arrange the following according to their increasing order of covalency. As you know, covalency is what? It is the number of electrons shared by an atom during covalent bond formation. Since cation is same in case of Na, NaF, NaCl, NaBr, NaI, cation is same, right? So among the since cation is same, compare the anion. Amongst the anion, larger the size, more would be the covalency. Larger size, you can see larger size of iodide ion. Fluoride has small size, chloride bigger than bromide, bigger than chloride, then ultimately iodide has the bigger in all. So therefore the order will be, if we have to compare it, if cation is same, then we have to compare with the anion. Larger the size of the anion, greater will be the covalency. So Nai will have the highest value of covalency and NaF will have the lowest value of covalency. Another, in another example, you can see LiF, NaF, KF, RbF, CF, cesium, fluoride. Here anion is same, cation is different. So here the case is reversed. So here we have to check. Anion is same, compare the cations. Among the cations, smaller the cation, more would be the covalency, right? Lithium will have the small size, and on moving top to bottom in a group, you will see the size will increase. Lithium ion will have small size, cesium plus has bigger size. So the order of covalency will be CSF will have the least covalency and LiF will have the highest value of covalency. Then FeCl3 is more covalent than FeCl2. Why? Because polarizing power, because higher is the charge, greater is the charge, greater will be the covalency. We have already discussed this thing. And likewise, SnCl4 is more covalent because here Sn will acquire more charge, that is plus 4, and SnCl2 will acquire Sn plus 2. Plus 2 charge here, and here plus 4 charge on the Sn tin. That's why greater the charge on the cation, greater will be the covalency. So in this video we have discussed about the Fajan's rule. So how Fajan rule is very important in deciding the ionic or covalent character. So I hope you will found this video useful. Have a great day. Thank you so much for watching it.